stepping into the world of intellectual freedom and unscripted ideation. You're listening to the Unstructured Pod with the Wizards of Wonder, Juan Farah
and Ethan Zaretsky. Get ready to break free from the confines of conventional thinking.
Episode 10 of the Unstructured Podcast. I'm Juan Farah.
And I'm Ethan Zaretsky. Welcome to this week's episode 10 of the Unstructured Podcast, a very special edition, winter break edition. Glad you guys could be here and listen and hear us and see us and everything. So glad you guys could be here. It's a Zoom edition. So, Juan, how you doing, bro? It's been like forever since I've seen you.
Yeah, it's been like literally a total of 7-8 days. It's been well,
it
Ethan. We were last week at Penn State and obviously watched the Flyers absolutely rinse on the Devils yesterday. Shout out Ben Wasserman for that. Ethan did a great job with his exams. But Ethan, how the hell are you doing?
I'm doing amazing, bro. I'm done with school. I got all my final grades back. Took my one teacher forever to get my grades back. You know exactly what I'm talking about if you know me well. And if you don't, you better know me better. So all my grades are in. I'm glad I did good. My last semester's coming up. And Juwan, it's really kicking in. Like, it's hitting me hard, bro. I don't know about
you. It's hitting you hard.
It's really bad.
Lionheart's hitting hard. Lion path is hitting hard. And guess what else is hitting hard? Apply to graduation in January. But look, a lot of juicy content. I sound like Ben Wasserman. I shouted him out twice now. Juicy content to talk about today. First thing that's on the top of my head is this. Tom Allen, co-defensive coordinator for the Penn State Nittany Lions, ex-Indiana head coach. Thoughts?
I saw this coming from a mile away. I mean, there was rumors and thoughts. There was rumors and thoughts of him coming to Penn State for, it seems like over a year now, finally comes into Penn State. I know we've had issues with our defensive coordinator in the past. Really excited to see what he could do for this team in the future with new teams coming into the Big Ten. It's going to be crazy next season when Penn State's playing divisional games with USC, Washington, and UCLA. It's insane. And Oregon, too. It's crazy.
Sounds like to me an alumni trip to LA, to Oregon, to the Northwest. That's what we're going to do.
Where are we playing at home next year? UCLA or USC? Whichever one I'm going to.
I got to look at the schedule, but wherever, which one, we got to make a trip, whether it's next year, the following year. But yeah, to your point, great segue. We're going from one to the next. Tom Allen to the then restructuring of the Big Ten. Interestingly, I'm going to say this. It's going to be upsetting not being able to see the Big Ten commercial with that like theme music. It makes me feel like I'm at Knoebels if you're in Pennsylvania, or Hershey Park type of like amusement theme music. But hey, that's okay. Now we have a transition. And I don't know if you saw Chip Kelly's comments. This is not related to the Big Ten, but I want to just side on this really quick. Chip Kelly's comments holistically about college football. Did you see what he said at the bowl game? Love to hear.
I didn't see what he said.
He basically said that the college football holistically, I said that word three times now, Juwan, should be independent. How Notre Dame is, how BYU is, how Army is. I think that's a really interesting component. He was basically talking about media rights and how each conference has its own deal, like Big Ten's with Fox, then you have SECs with CBS, and like all the different media right deals across the different conferences should just be a one, and we should all benefit off it. My whole thing is again, hierarchy, as in different conferences are bringing different amounts of revenue. There's relevancy aspects. We're not watching the seat UTSA. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Consistently.
I sorry to cut you off, but this is the Unstructured Podcast, but we need to talk about structured chaos. Shout out my boy, Sandy Cohen. If you're listening to this, you're the man, but there needs to be structure within this, because if you're going out there and every team, it can play anybody on any given day, you're going to have uneven matchups. And like we were talking about, as you're looking at the side, I don't know what you could possibly be looking at right now, not locked in. But as I was saying, you got to have structured chaos. Even though this is the Unstructured Podcast, got to talk a little bit about structure. I would love to see any team play any possible team, but you know, it's just not how this world works. And I love the way that the media rights are laid out.
100%. Yeah, I agree with you. And in terms of what I was looking at,
you just keep side eyeing. Like, people are looking at and be like, what is
we're recording this podcast, and my mother's actually across in the hallway right now as we're recording this podcast. She's over here. Shout out Mama Far. She doesn't want to be on the podcast, but shut the door behind me so she'll be able to talk to me after this. But to your point, all those things I agree with. Now, transitioning from that point into this. I believe that after college, I'm going to be a food connoisseur.
What does that even mean?
I'm going to go around, Ethan. I put out a business plan. Okay. I'm going to go around city to city, Guy Fieri style, but in my own way. Ask people what the word of the day is. Instead, it's going to be, what's the food of the day? And whatever that food of the day is, that person in the local community is going to tell me where to go for that. So if they say the food of the day is lettuce. Okay, so where am I going to get lettuce? The farmer's market? Giant? Like, I think it would be a great way to just, like, travel the country and make good content.
I love that idea. Shout out to my cousin. We're doing a lot of shout outs this episode. I love it. Episode 10, double digit episode. Thank you guys for being here. But yeah, like I said, shout out my cousin. He makes the funniest food. It's different than what you were saying, but he makes food reviews and they are so funny. Like, I gotta
better than Dave Portnoy. Better than Dave Portnoy.
It's different, but like, it's really funny. But I like that idea, Juan. A lot of people like food and it's easy content to grab onto.
100%. And it goes back to consistency. I mean, we're hitting professional development, self-development, food, football. What do we not hit on this podcast? But look, well,
comment right now what you want to hear about in the next episode, because you know, we're always, even though it's unstructured, we always love talking about the things you guys want to hear. So let me know.
100%. Let us know going into the new year what are the things you want to talk about. But back to the focal point, Ethan. I've been rambling about different content and different topics. What's on your mind right now?
The holidays. It doesn't even feel like Christmas is in 5 days. When you're listening to this, it's going to be 3 days until Christmas. The episode is releasing, 3 days before Christmas, on the 22nd. It doesn't even feel like it's Christmas time, even though it literally is peak holiday season right now. Hanukkah just wrapped up. New Year's is coming up. Honestly, I'm more excited for New Year's than I am for Christmas. I know that's crazy to say, but
is that the hot take on the podcast? Clip it.
It might be the hot take of the podcast.
Is New Year's better than Christmas?
I don't know. It's so different. Like, New Year's is I guess they're both celebrations, but New Year's is a different kind of vibe. And I feel like I get more excited for the New Year's, even though it reminds me that I'm getting older every year. But Juwan, when that ball drops in 2024, it's our graduation year. When we were in high school and saw 2024, we were like, that's so far away. It's never going to come. And in however many days, it's going to be 2024. It's crazy.
If I do my math correctly, then that is 10. It'll be 11 days, 12 days. Times, do the amount of seconds per minute if you want to get really in the nitty-gritty and be an MIS guy. Not a dig, by the way, at MIS. I love my analytics guys. But if you want to get the nitty-gritty of figuring out exactly how far we are from 2024. Go ahead and do that. But
yeah,
I mean, we're talking about shout outs.
Shout out Jerpa, by the way. That was crazy. That
we're talking about shout outs. Shout out Jerpa. Sherpa line, dude. I got to talk about my experience with this in 30 seconds or less. And I'm timing myself.
Elevator.
Freshman year, came into college, saw a lot of kids wearing masks. Great. What did it say on it? Sherpa. Okay. Instagram at Jerpa. Figured out Sherpa line hoodies, cold at Penn State. Prevents me from having to wear my Canadian goose. Oh, wait, I forgot. I'm not official. So I actually wear the Tommy Hilfiger jacket. And I was like, I'm in love with the brand. Truly loved it. Bought two hoodies. Reached out to the person and ended up being Austin Thomas. 30 messages over the course of 30 days. That means every day I was messaging him different ideas. Got be a pain in the butt. Joined as an ambassador. Pain in the butt more in the summer. Director of Athlete and Influencer Relations. Brings me all to my story of what I'm doing now.
Timothy. Now that was more than 30 seconds, but
perfect. Ethan's 30-second pitch on hockey today and literally being the face of comment about 6 months.
Started it on August 1st, grew it from 0 followers to 9,000 followers in 4 months. Great hockey content surrounding the entire world and making stories and headlines. And I just love being in front of the camera and making videos for Hockey Today.
Repeat what numbers you went from. Yeah, that is a pitch.
It went from 0 followers on August 1st, 2023, to over 9,000 followers as of December 20th.
I pause there because if that doesn't make you get up out of your chair, out of the toilet seat, out of the driver's or the passenger seat, if that doesn't get you out of wherever you're sitting, watching, running, whatever, and make you want to bang your head against the wall and say, let's go attack. I don't know what is else going to do that. A lot of motivation. It's not about the numbers that Ethan said. It's about the consistency of posting every single day and not just posting just to check it off the to-do list. It's to say, look, we're making quality There's a vision, and I think that aligns a lot with this podcast. We have a vision for what we want to do. Ethan and I have had these very, you know, very intense conversations because we care about making sure that this podcast is not just something that's kicking it. Yeah, we're just kicking it, but we want to see a vision of how this is going to inspire not just the next generation, the people that are listening, but how is this going to inspire people to make change in their own lives?
Exactly. I couldn't agree with you more there, Joan. I mean, I'm loving doing this podcast with you. It's crazy that it's been 10 weeks. I mean, just sitting on here talking to you, sharing our thoughts and feelings about maybe some current events, maybe some stories, maybe some things that are going on in our own lives. Like I love chopping it up with you, and I appreciate all you guys that are watching and listening from wherever you are.
100%. So. Ethan, I think we should end the podcast, this episode, with this. I know you and I have talked off air about a lot of different giveaway ideas, and we did that obviously with the Penn State hockey game. Mm. But for a road to 100, right, when we hit 100 followers on Instagram, I think there's got to be something special there.
We should give away 100 carrots.
To the horses, or?
I don't know. I have no idea. I was just being funny.
I know.
Hopefully someone got a laugh out of that one.
Hopefully someone got a laugh. If you're still listening, hopefully the retention's high and open rate is high. That'll do it for us. Episode 10 in the books. Like I said, if you haven't followed us already, Unstructured Pod on Instagram, Apple Music and Spotify coming soon, exclusively on YouTube for the visual component of these episodes. Lastly, 2024 is coming upon us. Don't just make it the year where in the beginning of the year you say, I'm going to get a membership at Planet Fitness and not touch it in March. Actually, think about tomorrow. Not January 1st, tomorrow. How can you take one step closer to looking yourself in the mirror at the end of the day when our time's up on this earth and say, I recognize that person, not I don't know who that person is that I was supposed to be.
Absolutely banger way to end the episode. Thank you for the kind words, Juan. Thank you for listening and watching to episode 10 of the Unstructured Podcast. We will see you next Friday at 1 p.m. Peace.